Hello everyone, welcome back to another episode of r/Tales from Tech Support. In today's episode, needing to vent, this is the right place I guess. I'll just bring it back and camp there till I get my money back. No, Mr. Engineer. You cannot insert a firewire cable into a USB port. Not every forklift truck driver has a driver's license. Before we get started, make sure to subscribe so you will never miss a video. So let's get started. Needing to vent, this is the right place I guess. So I work in IT, obviously, or wouldn't be posting here I guess, in state government. We have some people roll through with calls/emails/tickets that probably shouldn't be allowed around a TV remote, let alone Outlook and other state web-based applications. Here is but the latest one I spend 24 minutes on the phone with. Think about that again. 24 minutes on the phone. You will understand why this is so unbelievable in a moment. Okay, user has a ticket that he put in. In it says every time he opens up one browser-based program, another one closes out. No other supporting documentation. I blindly have the client, I've dealt with this person before. I reluctantly took the ticket as I'm the only one assigned to do so in my region, call me so we can begin troubleshooting. His English is very broken and hard to understand. He's hidden away in an obscure office attached to a medical facility, and I secretly think his bosses put him there simply because they can't fire people at the state. This guy is as dumb as a box of rocks. Me, yes sir, please click XX and let me know what your IP is. I will remote in and watch you duplicate the problem so I know what is going on. EU, the way out? Me, it's on your taskbar. Look for the blue circle with the lowercase x on it. EU, the what bar? 3 minutes go by before they finally figure out what I'm talking about. EU, IP address is xxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxxx please click it. I attempt to remote in 3 times over the next 4 minutes before he finally sees the box, and it doesn't time out, and I have to restart the entire process. Me, okay, I'm watching now. Can you please duplicate the problem so I understand what is going on? EU, opens up browser, goes to link for one state application. Loads said application. Then goes to favorites and clicks on another link. The browser redirects to another link. EU, that right there is the problem, see? Me, confused. No sir, what is the problem? EU, repeats the same thing again. I don't understand what is going on. Me, can you explain your issue? I apologize, but I'm not following along with what is going on. EU, watch again. When I click on my portal here, then click on my other portal, I need it closes out my first portal. 21 minutes into the call, and having it repeated 5 times. Me, you are trying to access both sites at the same time? EU, yes, every time I click on the other one it closes out my first one. I then spend 2 minutes explaining how to use the tab feature and or open in another window. Get off the phone with my wife laughing from head to toe grinning at me, can't stop laughing, I work from home, often work my IT tickets from home remotely unless I have to put physical hands on something. She's still laughing 15 minutes later as I type this up. Asterisk, this is not a new employee. They have been with the state for probably 10 plus years. They have to use the same software every single day to do their jobs. How they did not understand that by going to a whole nother website, while in their current browser without opening it in a new tab or browser window would close out the previous one is beyond me. I'm still in shock and awe at the stupidity of this. The dumbest people get jobs working for government. I'll just bring it back and camp there till I get my money back. So I've been advised to post in here. I'm not sure it counts as tech support, but my official job title is technical customer support, so it's something? I will be bleeping things to make reading easier. I work/am contracted for a large household appliance manufacturer. One of the things marketed are washing machines. While an online brand store exists, it's in its infancy and neither well-stocked nor maintained. So it's Thursday, it's nice and slow, we're having fun in the office, because who needs home office anyway? Ha 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 ha, and I get a call in. I start my usual gist. Manufacturer, my name is X, how may we he? Your bleep colleague just bleep hung up on me that bleep bleep. I check the first tickets. Today is the 29th. First contact on the 13th, needs service for his washing machine. Machine is 4 months old and too loud. Customer is afraid it will blow up any second. Refused troubleshooting. Technician called him on the 16th, but didn't receive an answer, so they're waiting for a reply from the customer. Bleep your customer service, what kind of bleep is that bleep bleep bleep? He already called on the 19th to complain about nobody calling him, and the colleague back then decided to make a big escalation ticket out of it. Reply from technician was, we called him, he just needs to give us a ring back and we can be there the next day. Bleep, I don't want the technician anymore, just give me my money back, you bleep, I never want TO have anything TO do with you again. We can't help you with that, if you want to return your machine you will have to return it where you bought it. Yeah, I want there, and they said they need a letter from you to do that. Bleep, give me that thing, you bleep bleep. I checked the ticket the colleague who hung up made. The store correctly told him that after a 14-day grace period, you need the manufacturer/technician to sign a paper that a machine is no longer able to be repaired so it can be processed as a return. Which of course he won't get because the technician hasn't seen the machine. That is correct. I just checked the tickets and the technician has tried contacting you on the 16th. You weren't reachab. I am always reachable, those lying bleep. They have left you a message on your mailbox asking that you call them back, so you can fix a date for a repair. Then give me their bleep number. For technical reasons, I am not allowed to. If you check your mailbox, you can easily find it, however. I don't have a mailbox. A mailbox is integrated in almost every mobile service. Please ask your provider if you're unsure how to ACC. I am from the countryside, I have no idea about this weird bleep. At this point I start having issues understanding what the customer is saying as his accent is getting worse. He is very much not from the countryside. In that case, please check your phone logs for unknown numbers on the 16th and call them back. I am the customer, I am king, why are you like this, you bleep 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 bleep. And I'm losing my patience. The technician has contacted you on the 16th. Please check your phone and mailbox and call them back in order to fix a date for them to come take a look at the machine. Incoherent angry words. The technician has contacted you on the 16th. Please check your phone and mailbox and call them back in order to fix a date for them to come take a look at the machine. More angry words, starting to talk while I am still talking. I ignore them. The colleague sitting across puts a Snickers in front of me. As I just said, the technician has contacted you on the 16th. Please check your phone and mailbox and call them back in order to fix a date for them to come take a look at the machine. I cannot do anything more from you at this point. Fine, I'll just bring it to the store and stay there until I have my money back. Okay, that's possible too, best of Lou. Click. I sigh and have a Snickers. I get sympathetic looks, we all know those customers. 2 hours later. Yet another colleague comes up to me. You know. A certain store just called us. There's an angry customer there with a washing machine. From what we gathered, the customer made his threat true, put the washing machine into the trunk of his car, drove to the store, and then entered it with the machine in a wheelbarrow and instantly started yelling at the next employee. It made the employee's day, and they apparently had to all rush behind the scenes in order to not burst out laughing in front of the customer. He tried claiming we refused service to him, but well. We have a good relation with most stores who sell our stuff. After a 2-minute chat, the last info we got was that the store employees were escorting the customer, who now did want a technician to come look at the machine, back to his car and helping him load the machine back in. They wanted to be sure he was gone before curfew. We applauded him being consistent with what he said he'd do, but we were all surprised and might have just regained a bit of respect for that guy. We also poked the technician and asked them to try calling the customer again. No, Mr. Engineer. You cannot insert a firewire cable into a USB port. Long-time electronics tech here. This is a story from my internship way back in the early 2000s. My school, like all credible schools, required us all to have a part-time internship for the last semester before we could graduate. After a few weeks of looking, I secured one at a local affiliate of a national radio network. The broadcast engineer for our station was special. Disorganized to the extreme. Only broadcast background. No computing background at all. Two best examples of that are: one, when I happened to stop in the office on my day off because I had forgotten something. We had just had a major thunderstorm blow through and knock out power. He is in the computer room on the phone with corporate tech support and getting very agitated. He shoves the phone in my hand and has me take over dealing with them. Turns out one of our critical servers that should have come back up on backup power wasn't coming back up. Turns out he didn't have that server plugged into a UPS or even a computer-grade surge protector. Lo and behold, it was completely fried. Rebuilding it with parts corporate sent out turned out to be a rather fun project for me the following week, despite everyone from the on-air talent, my boss, and the station director chomping at the bit to get this repaired and back online. Turns out it was part of the EAS system and they were facing fines every day it was offline, and they had to rely on other means to receive EAS messages. The second episode of his antics involved me installing a new PC and a new digital mixer board in two of our sound booths. I spent most of the first day getting the first booth upgraded the way he wanted it. The PC installed in the equipment box where he wanted it, and was routing the cables where they needed to go. I get to the point of hooking up the FireWire port on the mixer to the FireWire port on the PC he ordered. Home, no FireWire ports. Crap. I take the cable into him and explain the problem, tell him it can be fixed by a quick trip to Staples or Circuit City, yeah I know. He is not impressed. I'm an idiot, just bend it to fit into the port, WTF? No, that's not going to work. Nope, I don't know what I'm talking about. He snatches the cable out of my hand and reaches for a pair of needle-nose pliers to straighten things out. While Heavy's doing that, I turn to the computer on his desk and dogpile differences in USB and FireWire. I pull up a comparison picture just as he gets frustrated and gives up on the cable. He looks at what I found. Yells, "Why didn't you tell me that?" just as the director walks in the room to ask a question. After seeing things were getting a bit tense, the director asks what's up. We both give our sides of the story. I'm told to go work on the other booth, and the engineer gets an A*S chewing for the order mix-up and is sent to the store to get the expansion cards we need to finish up. 2 days later, when I'm next in the office, I finish the upgrades and get the new systems online. Much to the sound guy's delight. Apologies for formatting. I'm in that I need sleep, but my brain won't shut up mode right now. If I check this tomorrow, I doubt I'll like how it turned out. Not every forklift truck driver has a driver's license. Since working for the Chinese manufacturer of computer cases and PSUs and other computer-related hardware, I found out that there are a lot of third-party work suppliers choose to have the cheapest laborers. Keep this in mind because this is setting the stage for my next story. I received an email of a customer with the request if we could help with some parts for his case. He explained that when he was carrying his rig down Satairs to go to a lawn party, he fell down and busted his case really bad. And because of it, the frame was contorted. Did you hurt yourself? Yes, his pride and his rig. After asking which model the case was, I went to the warehouse to see if we had that older model still available. Now, when shippers handle our pallets full of cart-ton boxes with the latest model of cases, there is always a possibility of damage. With this particular case model, the forklift truck driver had punctured with the spoons two cartons because he had not lowered them enough to pick up the pallet. So we still had two useless cases which had punctures in the doors. I could take everything apart and ship the empty frame for a small fee to him, explaining to him why I was able to provide him with the frame so cheap. For the company, not a big deal since it was already a loss and was already paid out by the shipping company insurance. So actually not a very interesting story, you should say. But here is the kicker. Since that manufacturer has sales offices / persons in different countries who needs to keep an eye on any media coverage in their respective countries, a mail was sent company-wide. Who is the person who sold that frame to a customer? Since for the whole of Europe there is only one department who can independently sell items beside the sales department, it was clear the RMA department will have the culprit. Since I don't care about the fallout, I answered it was me. The colleague then wrote that there was a post from the customer on a site like Reddit raving about the length of effort I had put in to provide him with the frame and how cheap it was to get it. He only had to rebuild his rig and it was like new. Of course it was, because it was in fact brand new. I only removed the damaged parts and had sent the remaining frame and other parts. Now I told the customer about the fact there are terrible forklift drivers which can cause damage. In his article on that particular forum, he had recalled that fact and found it funny. Later I got a well-done mail from the general manager for doing such a good job. I had a bigger smile from the forum post of the customer because I did something which I would like to have done for me when I need such a big favor.